Hi, folks. I'm Father Joe Grimaldi. You can call me Joe, and I'd like to welcome you to my podcast. But now, here's our host and friend, Ken Calvert.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Father Joe Grimaldi podcast. I'm Ken Calvert alongside my dear friend, Father Joe Grimaldi, as we are celebrating podcast number 100 here over the weekend. And
what a celebration it is.
Jeez, can you believe it? Honestly,
it's hard to believe.
It truly is.
Time goes by when you're having fun.
It really does, and it seemed like a simple idea that I thought it had legs, but I wasn't sure that you thought it necessarily had legs.
Well, I was ignorant.
And not anymore.
I still am.
No, not anymore. You're a marvelous student, and you've taken to this podcasting rather nicely, and we certainly appreciate all the feedback we're getting, and thanks again. Congratulations on 100.
Congratulations to you.
100 podcasts. Hard to believe. The Father Joe podcast is proudly supported by Houghton McInerney Star Lincoln on 12 Mile Road and Telegraph in Southfield. And the 14th edition wish list sales event is going on now and runs through January 2nd, 2019. You can lease the 2019 Lincoln MKC for only $257 a month and the stunning new 2019 Lincoln Nautilus for only $387 a month. See Star Lincoln for details. Star Lincoln, 12 Mile Road and Telegraph in Southfield. Experience the star treatment. We've got so many topics and so little time.
Well, we can keep on going.
It's that time of year where we need to get out and our well-wishing and all of the great things that come with this time of year. We are recording today, December 19th. You brought up two different readings from the church's liturgy today, and both compelling, and quite frankly, I'm going to need you to walk me through them and explain them a little more clearly, if you could.
I can try.
Where would you like to start?
Well, the first reading would be the one from the book of Judges, and I think that's an interesting story. First of all, we have to keep in mind,
yes,
when we read the scriptures, they were inspired by these authors, so the authors were inspired by God. Huh? It wasn't that God dictated every little word, but the inspiration came from God. And so they also used the literary techniques to bring their points across. Since we are very close to the beginning of the Christmas season, even though people think it's almost the end of it, but anyway,
yeah.
The beginning of the Christmas season, yeah. It emphasizes, the two readings emphasize the unusual birth of Jesus Christ himself. Now, the thing is this, that the literary technique is that when you have important people in the scriptures, in order to emphasize the idea of their importance, they usually have a dramatic story about their birth. And so, for example, today we have a dramatic story about the birth of Samson, and then one of the birth of John the Baptist, both important in their own right.
Uh-huh.
You have Samson coming from the Jewish scriptures, particularly the idea of being the last judge, if you want, from the judges who ruled Israel at the time. And he's the one who eventually introduced the kings that followed. So Saul would be the first king of Israel,
followed by
David, probably the most popular, the most loved, the most prolific, how should I put it, ruler of Israel. So naturally something had to be done about emphasizing the importance of Samson, besides his friend Delilah that everybody knows.
Sure.
Okay,
yeah.
He lost his power with that, but anyway, because the angel appears to the wife of Manoah and says to her, you ought to bear a son. Now, she was shocked because she was barren, couldn't have kids.
Right.
However, she was able to convince her husband that this was the will of God, and sure enough, little Samson was born eventually, and Samson was born and was raised in such a way that he was not to have hard drink, he was not to have, nothing should touch his hair, and he was preparing for great things in the future.
Fascinating that even back then, so many hundreds of years ago, stay clean, be without wine, be without poor food habits.
Yeah, getting ready to,
I'm sort of paraphrasing
to do something great
and
things.
Making and modernizing it, using my own drama, if you will. But
sure.
It's very similar to the same sort of orders that women follow now as they're in the pregnancy phase.
Correct,
So go ahead.
And then, of course, we see where the birth of Samson takes place, and he's the one who initiates or brings in the new era of kings that were to rule Israel. Okay, the story of John the Baptist is also very dramatic, again, because John the Baptist is the bridge between the Old Testament and the New Testament, the bridge between the Jewish scriptures and the Christian scriptures. He's the one who kind of initiates Christianity, preparing himself for his cousin to arrive on the scene, and that's Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
And so he preached the gospel of repentance. And Jesus, of course, came to preach the gospel of the Spirit, different types of baptism. One is the baptism of repentance, as John the Baptist was baptizing people in the Jordan River. And of course, then he also baptized Jesus Christ, his cousin. And Jesus Christ initiated his ministry under the guidance of John the Baptist as well. Anyway, the birth of John the Baptist is also brought out in a very emphatic way, because you have Elizabeth and you have her husband Zechariah, who were elderly people. And sure enough, Zechariah is working in the back of the temple one day, and sure enough, the angel appears to him and says to him, "You ought to bear a son." And so he was shocked. And of course, it had to be a laughing matter for him as well as his wife. You know, it happens also with Abraham's story as well. But anyway, that's another topic. But basically, it was a laughing matter. How can we have children in our old age? Well, all things are possible with God. So Zechariah doubted the angel, doubted the will of God, and so he was silenced. He could no longer speak. And so when he came out...
Oh, wait, now stop. He was punished, right?
Correct.
Meaning he could no longer speak.
He could no longer speak.
Did he see that angel?
The angel appeared to him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and so then when he walks out...
Uh-huh.
People are wondering what went on. He couldn't say anything because he doubted the word of the Lord. And so it was at the birth of John the Baptist, you know, people were saying, well, we have to name him Zechariah, you have to name him so-and-so. And that's the first time that Zechariah could eventually speak. He says, no, his name is to be John, because the angel told them that his name was going to be John.
Uh-huh.
And it was an unusual thing because it was kind of out of the family situation, usually naming him maybe after the father.
I have to stop you for a second, because did Zechariah, John's father, who had been punished for, let's say...
Not believing.
For not believing and for 9 months, he just assumed he wouldn't be able to say, vocalize, his name will be John. He thought he'd probably have to write it down. Is that correct?
Correct. Oh, yeah. But other people were saying, well, what's his name? What's his name? And they looked to him, and he was about to write it, but no, he was able to speak the name. He was able to verbalize what the angel had told him. And this John the Baptist, of course, is the herald of Jesus Christ. So you could see how these things lead up to the Messiah eventually.
Sure.
And so it's the birth of Samson, the birth of John the Baptist, all dramatic. And of course, Jesus' birth is also super dramatic because it's the Holy Spirit that allows Mary to conceive, and she was a virgin, and she gives birth, and she's also remains a virgin, and she gives birth to the Son of God. And this is why she's called the Theotokos, which is the Greek words God-bearer, because she was human, but she bore God in Jesus Christ.
Okay, is there a coincidence, or am I just making a coincidence, that on one hand with David and Samson in that entire part of the liturgy, and then the second part being the birth of John the Baptist, And John was the bridge from one religion, basically, to Christianity, correct?
Correct.
The bridge from Judaism?
Correct.
To Christianity? Is it a coincidence that both of those readings would occur today? Or is it done by design?
It's done by design because, David, about the birth of Jesus Christ.
Okay.
He's in the line of David.
Okay.
See, the thing is, the prophecies always said that the Messiah would come in the line of David.
Right.
So how is he in the line of David? Well, you have to read the genealogy of Jesus Christ. And, of course, in the line of David, even though he was not the natural father of Jesus, Joseph was in the line of David.
Really?
And so they tie it in there that way. We have to understand that literary techniques are important to bring across what the writers want us to see.
Well, a good writer has to sort of utilize some color, some flavor, some drama. Yeah. Some panache, if you will.
You got it. So, you look at the scriptures, it's not a book of facts. It's a book of faith.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to always emphasize the idea that this is written so that people will understand better and would believe better in God's powers and God's will.
Which is exactly what I do during the podcast, because if you'll notice, in this case, I am truly the student on this one.
Come on, don't be so modest.
No, serious, though. I mean, that's why I'm riddling you with what I consider to be probably, for people listening right now, some basic questions.
Well, that's
and maybe
good.
They're beyond that, but I still am curious, and I would rather do it that way.
Sure, by all means.
Yeah, for the sake of those out there that are in my camp, you know what I mean, when I never knew that.
Well, that's great.
So we continue, sir. I'm glad we
were able to do a little bit on that. So, but it's great to see the way the techniques were used. And so we see the drama in the birth of Jesus, which is about to happen, the celebration of which is about to happen. We see that Samson's birth was dramatic, John's birth was dramatic, and, of course, Jesus' birth is dramatic.
And only the beginning on Christmas Day. Let's remind people
of that again.
Yeah.
Because we keep celebrating it for the 12 days of Christmas.
Yep.
Well, the 12 days of Christmas culminate in the Feast of the Epiphany, which is when Jesus appears to the three kings. He doesn't appear, but he's there. The three kings who come from the east, symbolizing Jesus came for all people, not just Jews.
Yeah.
In the beginning, Jesus came for the Jewish people, but it was for all people. So let's put away our prejudices because he's here for everybody.
Yeah, it's an aggregate of this world of nations.
The world population. Yeah. Because these learned people from the East, whatever that means, okay? In other words, foreigners, they were made up of all different races, huh?
All right, now, as I mentioned earlier, I am the student in the classroom here. You said something at the beginning, before we started recording, that I wanted to go back to.
Sure.
About the confusion of Paul and Saul. Saul was the first king. David was the second. Paul was also known as Saul, so a lot of people confuse Paul with Saul because they were both Sauls. Correct?
Correct. In the beginning...
Pardon my laughing, but that was fairly difficult for me, to just reconstruct for you.
You know, right after Christmas, not too long after, we celebrate the Feast of St. Stephen, the first martyr, and it's kind of interesting because Paul was in the background. Saul was in the background. Mm-hmm. Now, we're speaking hundreds of years difference. So Saul, the first king, and then Saul, who later became Paul, he was the one who persecuted Christians. Huh? And so he's there. He's absolutely inspired by the martyrdom of Stephen. And they say that that was probably the beginnings of his faith journey in following the Christians instead of persecuting Christians. And of course, with his change of heart, he has to go through some type of discernment and thinking and meditation. He now becomes Paul, who is the great writer of Scripture and also the great proponent of Christianity. He probably makes Catholicism come to life because of his writings. In any case, that was the Saul of the New Testament, if you want.
Uh-huh.
But the Saul that you mentioned before is the first king of Israel.
Yeah.
Hundreds of years before that.
But you could see where people could indeed get confused on occasion.
Well, there's a story of a person defending his thesis, and he makes one fatal mistake when he was asked the question, who was the first king of Israel? And he responds, oh, that's Saul, who later became Paul.
Yeah.
Well, sure enough, he didn't pass.
He wasn't listening.
He slipped out.
He wasn't. If only there had been the Father Joe podcast.
That's right. Then
he would have aced that exam.
Exactly.
He would have gotten a big fat A on that exam.
He probably did anyway. But
well, yeah, because his heart was in the right place.
That's right.
Absolutely. Well, okay then. In my case, class dismissed. Thank you, Father Grimaldi.
Thank you, too. You're being very, very humble. But by the same token, yeah, the readings are beautiful. You can see how we're heating up towards the celebration of the birth of Christ,
you bet.
Which is also highly unusual.
Want to thank you, Father Joe Grimaldi, and we want to thank everybody out there for listening, continuing your support, along with the support of Hoot McInerney Star Lincoln at 12 Mile and Telegraph in Southfield. Stop on by, say hi, get that Father Joe Star treatment.
I think this is a wonderful 100th episode of the Father Joe podcast, and I have to thank you, Ken.
Congratulations.
Because you're the one who kind of instigated things and got things rolling. So,
and ladies and gentlemen, as a for your background, you'd be surprised what can happen over a Coney Island hot dog. All you have to do is invite an old friend to lunch and say, I got an idea. And the next thing you know, you're counting backwards from 100, so congratulations.
And what is a podcast? That was the question.
All right. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next time on the Father Joe Podcast.
God bless you. This is Father Joe Grimaldi, and I look forward to seeing you next time on the Father Joe Podcast.
If you'd like, you can email us. It's FRJOEPODCAST@gmail.com. That's FRJOEPODCAST@gmail.com. We're also on Facebook. Simply search Father Joe Grimaldi. And thanks for listening, everyone.